EduLender was built on the mantra that no only means no for now. Founder Sue Khim dropped out of a pre-med program in 2009 at the University of Chicago to develop the student loan comparison service. She entered business plan competitions and scrambled for months to find financing for what she calls the lending tree of student loans. But in January of 2010, she learned she would not receive the funding she needed.
That was devastating. And at that time, I was sure that EduLender was not going to continue, that I should go back to school, you know, put my head back in the books, go to medical school, and, you know, continue on the path that I had started out on.
Advisors encouraged Khim to stick with EduLender. She picked up contract programming work and planned her next move.
We give 2 million students each year a better way to find $20 billion in student loans.
That move would be Accelerate Lab's summer program, where she says she and her two co-founders regain momentum. But after demo day last August, the company's future was still uncertain.
There was no clear indication that we were ever going to raise money for the company. We were fast running out of cash to sustain ourselves. So the option was find jobs or borrow money. And we did both. We did contract work, worked on EduLender whenever we could. In the meanwhile, I was also out fundraising. So it was a really challenging time.
Khim and her team borrowed money from friends and family before closing on their first round of venture and angel capital, $1 million, in December. She's the only entrepreneur ever to appear twice before the quarterly meeting of the Hyde Park Angels. Advisory board Bob Rosenberg explained why.
And she came back with a much smarter approach to the marketplace that didn't copy others, but actually set its own standards for integrity and entrepreneurial vision. And Sue's one of those people who, and you can talk to many of the investors in EduLender, they will tell you, I'm investing in Sue, I may not be investing in EduLender. There's a point at which Sue, in her entrepreneurial life, is going to be a success.
Then it was like a crazy 13 weeks.
Like so many entrepreneurs, the idea for EduLender came from Khim's need. She had already taken on $50,000 in debt from 2 years at U of C and was about to take on more. She was looking for loans for herself and her brother and quickly decided that it was difficult to find a diversity of lenders.
I wanted to make sure that every single lender who was doing loans, that there was a directory that showcased all of their rates, fees, and terms and compared them side by side, so that for any student or parent who's coming to the site, they would be able to see side by side every single loan that they're eligible for and compare very transparently the deal that they would get into those loans.
The ranges are really big.
For free, EduLender offers student loan comparisons, loan summaries, and a tool for students to fundraise for their education. The company's revenue comes from fees for premium features, like the process of consolidating loans. Khim would not offer any details on revenue or profits, only saying that the site's traffic has grown month over month. Khim and her team did what the government says was too difficult to do. A General Accounting Office report released just last September said building a federal web-based tool for private loans was unnecessary and too expensive to maintain. Khim read about the report in the Chronicle of Higher Education.
I spent most of the day on the phone trying to get somebody from the GAO or somebody from the Chronicle on the phone to talk to them and say, hey, you know what, it can be done, it has been done. You should talk about it. It's a public service.
And while Rosenberg says EduLender will either be a success and flipped in 2 years or fail, Khim has another measure of success, changing the statistic that only 2 out of 5 college-bound high school seniors know how much debt they will have after graduation.
3 to 5 years from now, if every single high school college-bound senior and every single college student and graduate knows exactly how much debt they have, or you know, even a ballpark estimate of how much debt they have and what their payments are going to be after graduation, like, will have been very successful.